Hello friends, my name is Bintou and welcome or welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to do my fiction November wrap up. So if you haven't checked out my first wrap up with all the nonfiction books that I read this month, go ahead and do that. And with that said, let's get on to those books. So first I'm going to start with my favorite books that I read this month, my favorite fiction books, and then I will talk about my least favorite. There was actually only one dud in terms of fiction, or actually in general this month, because I liked all of the nonfiction books that I read. But the first book is This Beast, Rhythm of War by Brandon Sanderson. So I finished this a couple of days ago. Actually, I should have calculated how long it took me to read this book. But with like Thanksgiving break, I had some time. However, I also got a hold of like the Hyrule Warriors game on the Nintendo Switch. So that took away from my reading time there. But Rhythm of War was every bit as epic as I was expecting it to be. And I loved it, particularly the end. I mean, part five will just take you on like this roller coaster of emotions. It was just one big grand adventure. And by the time I got to the end of this book, I was so sad that it was over, especially knowing that it's gonna be at least maybe 3 years before we get the fifth installment of the series. But I know he's doing like these five book arcs. So like the fifth installment will be the end of the first arc of the Stormlight Archive. So I'm really looking forward to that. This book was mainly supposed to be from Venli's perspective. That being said, I don't feel like it made me particularly like Venli more. I did learn more about Venli, but it was kind of one of those things where the more you learn, the more you're like, okay, like she's kind of a coward. She gets better throughout the book, but definitely Venli is not my favorite of the characters. If anything, this book served to really elevate Navani's status in the series and as a character for me, an important character for me. I walked away from this book just in absolute awe of the character Navani. I loved all of the scenes that had Navani in them. And in this book, it was particularly Navani and a counterpart, one of the Fuse, Rabonio. And they were kind of, they're enemies, but they're stuck working together and trying to trick each other. It was a lot of fun to read their dynamic. And throughout this entire book, the war is still ongoing between the humans and the Fused. We learn a little bit more about what happened on that first night where the king was killed in that very first scene of the very first book. So we hear about it from the singer's perspective. And we're also going to learn just a little bit more about the Spren. So there's another trip into Shadesmar in this book. Overall, this was definitely a five-star read. I knew it was going to be. I loved it so much. And now I just have to wait patiently for the next one. The next book on my list is The Mountain Sing. And I'm not going to be able to pronounce this author's name, so I'm not going to try. But I do know that this book was it's a relatively new release. It was definitely released in 2020. I don't think there was a lot of hype behind this book because I haven't seen any YouTubers talk about it, or none of the ones that I follow on BookTube have talked about it. Although I have seen it on display in like Barnes & Noble and whatnot. And it's too sad because this was such a beautiful book. So this book follows a particular family in Vietnam. And it's following how their lives have been affected after the rise of communism and then eventually the Vietnam War, which kind of tore apart this family. So members of the family are going missing or they've died in the conflict between the North Vietnam and South Vietnam, as well as the American troops that came in during the Vietnam War. This book is full of Vietnamese language and culture, food, all of that is here. It is, and probably my favorite part is all of the little proverbs that the author throws in there in Vietnamese and then translated into English. I think that the characters were amazing. It's two storylines actually, so it follows the grandmother and granddaughter and the different conflicts that they both had to face, where the grandmother had to deal with, it was like the Great Hunger. There was a huge famine that came across Vietnam. And then there was a land reform where landowners were kind of, their properties were stripped away from them and then they were murdered or exiled. And then the granddaughter is living in the time of the Vietnam War where her mom and dad and uncles had to go serve for their country. Again, an absolute beautiful story about all the different ways that these families and these friends are able to help each other, and sometimes just perfect strangers when they're all faced with these impossible situations. The only note of criticism that I have for this book is the writing could feel a little bit simplistic at times. And I think that has to do with the fact that this is the author's first novel in English. So she is a Vietnamese author. This is her first novel in English. And that's likely the reason why. still though, it was a very, very beautiful, beautifully written book, and I'm really glad that I read this. I think I gave it 4 or 4.5 stars. All right, next book on my list is Zikora by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. This came out of nowhere. I didn't know it was coming out, and it's it was just released on, I think, Kindle Unlimited, just one day out of nowhere. I got an email and I saw the author. I was like, I have to snatch this up. I love Chimamanda's work. And this is a very, very short story. And I do mean, like, it is very, very, very short. I actually picked up, so both the audio and ebook were released, and I just picked up the audiobook, went on a walk during my lunch break, and finished the entire thing in that one short walk. And that, in fact, was the only thing that I didn't like about the story, was that it was just too short. I feel like this book, or this short story, could have, like, this plot could have extended into an entire book. And if it ever does, I would pick that book up. I really enjoyed it. So the story starts with Zikora. She is the main character, and she's in a hospital, and she's giving birth. And then you slowly start to learn that the father of the baby had suddenly abandoned her when he realized she was pregnant. And they're both, like, two very successful people, but he just wasn't ready for a kid, and he just abandons her. And so she's stuck in a hospital with her mother, who they have a very strained relationship. So her mother is acting very coolly toward her, and she's kind of just, I guess, distraught would be the best way to describe that. It's a pretty difficult situation that she finds herself in. And so the rest of the book is just the details of how she got here, and also her worries about becoming a mother and her insight into her own mother, since they don't get along very well, but she's starting to, like, understand her own mother as well. Awesome book. And I definitely recommend it. It's very short. It won't take you very long to listen or read this at all. So the next book on this list is Happily Letter After, and this is by Vi Keeland and Penelope Ward. And I think those two have come together on several romance novels that are available on Amazon. And this book was, it was a lot of fun, and it was just really funny as well. I really enjoyed this one. So Sadie, the main female lead, she writes for this magazine. And one of the columns that she writes for is a holiday column with Santa. And so a little girl in New York City, her name is Birdie, she sends in a letter to Santa. And Sadie starts fulfilling Birdie's wishes. And she's going to, like, pretty drastic extremes to do this. So, like, she sends Birdie a package with, like, socks for her dad and various other things. And so Sadie, or Birdie, thinks this is all Santa's doing. And one of the things she also mentions is that she wants her dad to have a new girlfriend, since the mom slash wife passed away from cancer. So what kicks the story off is basically Sadie is in their part of town, and she comes across Birdie's house, which she recognizes from the letters, the address, and she knocks on a door, and then they think she's, like, the dog trainer, and she goes along with it and pretends to be, like, this German dog trainer, not speaking any German. And then from there, it basically becomes your classic romance. There is an additional storyline that makes this a little bit more interesting, where it's got one of those, like, 23ME plot lines where you eventually discover that there is some sort of familiar relationship that exists between two characters that previously had no idea. That is a trope that's becoming a lot more common in a lot more books lately. I wonder how often in real life this happens. But yeah, Happy Letter After, very fun, very enjoyable. I would say this is about 4 stars. I enjoyed it. And that brings us to Take a Number by Amy Daws. It was just released, I think it's book 4 now in this series. I forget the name of the series, but I know I've read the first 3. I think I read them all in 1 month. It was 1 month where I discovered them and just read them all. This one was one of my favorites for sure. I was not too impressed by the third one, but this one was really awesome. First of all, it's set in a Croina bakery, which is like a croissant and donut mix. And I have to say, reading this and, like, reading about the main character basically waking up and preparing these pastries made me want to go out and grab a donut. And I did, in fact, do that. And then I remembered why I don't actually eat donuts that often, because the amount of sugar just didn't sit well with me. But anyway, this is a fake dating romance between Dean and Nora. Nora owns the bakery and Dean works there. He does work on his computer. I forget exactly what it is. He trades stocks or something like that. And then they start fake dating to get Nora's parents off her back and to get Dean's friends off his back. And then the story pretty much proceeds exactly as you would expect it to. That's one of the things about these romances, is, like, I don't know what else to say. You kind of know how romance books will end pretty much always. It's just the different journeys that the characters go on that adds to the fun of those books. So those are my five favorite fiction books that I read this month. And then the last book that I read was What We Were Promised by Lucy Tan. And this one was kind of a dud. So the book is mostly set in China. Actually, it's entirely set in China. And it's following this Chinese family. So it's a husband, a wife, and their daughter. And they were originally from China, and they grew up in the rural parts farming. They were not very wealthy. And then the son gets a scholarship to study in the United States. I think he actually went to the Wharton School. And so the wife goes along, and they settle there for a while. They have their daughter, and then they move back to China, and now they're very wealthy. And they live in this hotel. Yeah, it's like a hotel where there are these maids that help these wealthy families. And then part of the story is told from the point of view of the maid. The book follows their lives. Basically, it kind of just follows their lives. There is one storyline that comes up where the wife, you discover, had some sort of feeling for her husband's brother. And so that gets explored a little bit. Overall, this book was just very boring. The storyline wasn't interesting. And even that one storyline that I mentioned with the wife and the brother, it's like it builds up to this reveal, and the reveal wasn't great. And then it was just glossed over, and everyone got over it within like literally a page. So it kind of just discounted that whole plot. And it's a relatively long story. I mostly just listened to the audiobook for it. But yeah, it's just a long story of not much happening. The one thing I did like about this book, though, is that it kind of gives these really awesome descriptions of Shanghai as the characters are kind of making their way through the city. And that was really cool to read about. But other than that, I got through it because I was listening to the audiobook as I was doing other stuff. But I didn't really enjoy this, and I give this about 2 stars. All right, guys, that's it. Those are all of the fiction books that I read this month, a total of 6. And then I think I read 5 nonfiction books. So I got through 11 books this month, which is pretty great. I'm pretty happy with that. I'm genuinely surprised. I mean, Hyrule isn't saving itself. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.